1999 was a good year, for the most part. Got a house, found a job. But most importantly of all, found the love of my life to share it all with. All this before the world saw the millennium come ding-donking on in. All that's changed. I had a note shoved under my door telling me my wife has been held at ransom. I need 100 grand in my pocket. And the meeting point is the Hill Bar at 12 o'clock sharp. Tough night for one of the city's brightest stockbrokers.
Hello? Victor Lawson. It's been such a long time. How are you?
Could be a lot better.
Sit. Shit's gone down, Charlie. I've heard whispers and stuff like this happening before.
Slow down. Stuff like what?
Hostage situations.
Yeah? And you have one?
The wife.
I'm sorry to hear that. I assume they're asking for something in return for her.
Yes.
How much?
100 grand.
There might be something I can do.
What can you do?
Send in a decoy?
A decoy?
I don't know. A bomb, fake cash, and then a raid's carried out. But as you're my friend, Victor, and only because of that, I'm offering you a safe way out.
Safe way?
I could just give you the cash, pretend nothing ever happened. Hi, Caroline. Is there any chance you could withdraw some money from the bank's main account, please? £100,000 in cash, please, Caroline. Thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot for this, Charlie.
No worries. You just don't want to see anyone get hurt.
And hopefully, you won't have to.
You can pick up the money in a briefcase on your way out, okay?
PM, and 20 minutes until decision time. The meeting point is right here. So is the £100,000 in my hand to exchange. A hefty price to pay, but what I get in return is worth a whole lot more. Or I could be walking into a whole load of trouble. As I said, tough night for this typical stockbroker.
Thank you. then it's right here.
I'm here! Just take the money and end this.
Why? I don't understand. Why are you doing this? I love you.
Victor Lawson, can you hear me? Answer yes or no.
Yes.
Fantastic. Now we can get started. Do you have any idea why we brought you here? Answer yes or no.
No.
Want an explanation?
Yes.
Good. To get one thing out of the way, the £100,000 you so kindly donated to us was a test of your loyalty. A test that you succeeded in. So congratulations. But this test most importantly proved that you had the longevity that we had hoped for. Answer yes or no. Do you want to free your wife?
Why? She's working for you, isn't she?
I believe I said yes or no answers. You are mistaken, Victor. That was not your wife. Nothing more than a mere decoy. Amazing what drugs can do, right? You're going to run a little errand for us, Victor. £100,000 was just the warm-up. Yes. Yes, it's exactly what you're thinking. You're going to help us literally break the bank.
What?
Well, you've got access to the third floor, don't you? All you need to do is go to the storage room and get a disc marked past backup. What is on the disc is not of your concern. When you've retrieved it, meet us on the top floor of Newborough Car Park. I don't need to remind you that if you're not here, your wife will die.
Understood.
Fantastic. Anyway, In the next 2 seconds, my colleagues will come and collect you and allow you to get on with the task at hand.
Blackmail is a funny thing, really. A bribe like no other. A form of criminality that can force one man down to his knees begging for a second chance. My time to reconsider was now. I didn't know what was coming. Death, or a big party celebrating my foolishness. I, for one, couldn't wait for the outcome.
I really didn't think you'd be alone, Victor. You proved me wrong. You are good.
Ah, really? Not this time it was you.
Yes.
The notes.
Yes.
The kidnap.
Yes.
And this.
Yes. And you're going to give it to me, now.
You give me back my wife first.
I think you'll find I'm the one calling the shots here, Victor. Now please, before anyone gets hurt, give it to me.
Times are really changing, aren't they? A new millennium. A new world full of exciting possibilities, and you chose this day of all days to frame me. Why me? Why my wife?
I think you'll find your way is capable. Victor.
Capable.
Did your stockbroker such as yourself exact never have raised an eyebrow?
Depends. Everyone has their own weaknesses. Even me.
Oh really, Victor? You're good. You can't change the outcome of this. It's already been decided. Now give it here.
I could be mad enough to break this. Put the gun down, Charlie.
Oh, really? We've already framed you. You think I'd be so stupid as to let you waltz up here and threaten me without preparation? It's quite simple. The bank saw you take the disc from the storage room. The whole world will be convinced that you're the culprit. So really, we have two options here. Either you can spend the rest of your life lying in a jail cell thinking about your dead wife, or you can give it to me, and you can go start a new life somewhere else. Give it here.
It's okay. It's okay. It's over now. It's over.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
What's wrong?
Took care of him. And Charlie. Yes, yes, I know. His service was no longer required. Okay. I'll be there tonight. Bye.
Love sure is complicated. It can either make you the happiest man in the world, or turn you into a monster. World. It was the wife who turned into one. She was one of the bad guys. Unlucky me. I'm a dead man now. I'm actually kind of glad she put me out of my misery. Whoever she really is. It's up to the others now to stop whatever has started. It's their deal now. And they are the ones that need to take it.
How are you?
Could be a lot better.
Sit.
Shit's gone down, Charlie. I've heard whispers and stuff like this happening before.
Slow down. Stuff like what?
Hostage situations.
Yeah? And you have one?
Wife.
I'm sorry to hear that. I assume they're asking for something in return for her.
Yes.
Hello? Victor Lawson. It's been such a long time. How are you?
99 was a good year, for the most part. Got a house, found a job. But most importantly of all, found the love of my life to share it all with. All this before the world saw the millennium come ding-donging on in. All that's changed. I had a note shoved under my door telling me my wife has been held at ransom. $100,000 in my pocket. And the meeting point is the Hill Bar at 12 o'clock sharp. Tough night for one of the city's brightest stockbrokers.
There might be something I can do.
What can you do?
Send in a decoy?
A decoy?
I don't know, a bomb, fake cash, and the raids carried out. But as you're my friend, Victor,